It's a dish for a special occasion. Mm. It's not a budget recipe. It's using fillet of pork. It's porked pork with a mushroom cream sauce. And if you use for this recipe pork fillet, mm. and it's a very good buy because you get hardly any fat. There's just a little bit here that needs trimming off.
Very lean.
And about 1.25 pounds is enough for 4 people. Now, if you can't get hold of the fillet of pork, sometimes they run short, you could use chicken, which would be a bit more reasonable. And to start with, you brown the pork, and I've cut it into slices, fairly big, about 1.5 inches across. Mm. So to begin with, I'm going to put a little oil and butter in the pan and fry it off. How about that for a tablespoonful of cooking oil and 1 ounce of fat.
It's just butter. To seal the juices in, is it really?
That's right. Mm. Now you can see I've already got a plate heating here because I want to fry it off quickly. Mm. And I'm not adding to this any pepper and salt at this stage or flour. I'm going to just quickly put it into the heat and brown it off. Now you can hear it sizzling already. The reason for adding butter, oil to the butter, is to stop it getting too brown, because mm. if you heat butter to a high temperature, it goes, as you know, a sort of a burn.
Mm.
So 1.25 pounds.
Mm. All cut out into 1.5 inch cubes.
And just seal that off until it's brown. Now that'll take a few moments, so I can talk about the cream that I'm going to put in. Now, remember I mentioned that it was thick. Now this is only the fat content of single cream, but it's homogenised and it's beautifully thick, so it's going to make the sauce nice and thick. There we are. And you don't want to add the cream until the very last minute. If you do add it sooner and you give it a good boil for, say, 5 minutes or so, mm-hmm. you'll be in trouble. It'll curdle. So I shall be adding it at the last minute. Now I'm going to take, this isn't quite brown enough, but I'm going to lift it out and start doing the other ingredients. Now I've got a metal plate there and a piece of kitchen paper, and I'm going to lift it out. Now ideally this wants to be a little bit browner than it is now. But I want to show you all the processes, not keep this waiting. Here we are. Now I'm going to add the onion, and I'm going to take it, pull the board over and pull the onion in.
Sorry.
Here we are.
And just stir the onion round, chopped finely, of course.
Chopped finely, and I've used a Spanish onion. And then I'm going to add paprika pepper, a tablespoonful of paprika pepper. It's the cayenne pepper that's strong.
Looks very fiery, actually, doesn't it? It looks stronger than it is.
Let's give it a... It gets a bit solid down the bottom.
Mm. Quite deceptive, that, you know.
A tablespoonful of paprika pepper. And a level tablespoonful of flour.
It's plain flour, is it?
Plain flour. I always use plain flour for sauces. Doesn't matter if you use self-raising. Just whatever you've got. Mustn't do it the other way around, though, for baking.
No.
So, I've just turned the onion for 1 or 2 minutes, added the paprika, and I'm now going to add the liquid. 1/2 pint of water. There we are. A stock cube, because you wouldn't have any stock available using something like pork fillet.
What if you'd use the chicken?
You wouldn't have any stock because you'd be using fresh
chicken. So you'd
use
a chicken stock.
That's right. Mm-hmm. Little sherry. Cooking sherry, cheapest available.
How many dollars are that?
5 tablespoonfuls. Ooh, that figure. Should we call that 4?
I think we better.
I have a heavy hand when I come to add drink to cooking, so let's call that 5. There we are. And then I'm going to return the meat to here and simmer it for about 1/2 an hour. 1/2 an hour, depending on how much you've browned the meat to begin with.
Mm. And the salt and pepper, have you
Thank you. Salt and pepper.
Is that, yes.
Just a little salt and pepper.
Well, it wouldn't
now.
Be the same without your salt and pepper.
Best to add it at this stage.
Is it? Here.
I use about a teaspoonful of salt per pound of meat.
Mm.
Now, simmer that for half an hour to 40 minutes. Mm. And I've got one. All change. There we are. We've got one now that has simmered for that amount of time. Now, you can see that's a lovely consistency.
Mm.
If you like a sauce a little bit thicker, you can add a little bit of corn flour, about a level tablespoonful, with a little water, and thicken it again.
Mm.
So that is quite ready, except for adding some mushrooms, which add flavour. And I've got 6 ounces of mushrooms here, sliced.
And you just do this, Mary, don't you, obviously, just before you serve it?
Yes. Well, if you're doing this for a special party, you would cook the pork in the sauce up to the stage before adding these mushrooms.
Mm-hmm.
And then you would cool it, put it in the refrigerator, perhaps do it in the morning, and put it in the refrigerator. Then you would reheat it, add the mushrooms, and make sure it boils for about 2 minutes. And then the very last thing, that really wants to simmer for about 2 minutes now. And then right near the end, just when the guests are sitting down, they've had their first course, rush out, get this cream, and then just stir it in.
Mm.
You see, it's a lovely, thick consistency.
Got a bit of a bite to it, that, hasn't it? Which
yes,
obviously.
And it's fresh. Mm. Now, if you haven't got sour cream, in some country districts, it's still a little bit difficult to get. If you can't get it, you can sour your own double cream, which will be thick, with a tablespoonful of lemon juice.
What, just blend them together?
Blend them together, and that will still have some of it. So there we are.
That smells very good.
And then into the dish, which should be heated.
Very nice, it smells.
I'll put that on that plate. That particular plate isn't on. And then I would serve it with a little green salad or something like broccoli. There we are.
Very good.
And it's a dish for a really special occasion.